So there's three things that we wanted to accomplish with the very early product realization tool suite that we developed. One is help our scientists communicate their new discoveries and phenomena to soldiers better. The second thing was to engage soldiers to give us critical feedback, what they like, what they don't like, what the application space they might see that we didn't think of could be. And the third thing is to vector the technology towards a capability that is likely going to be very successful and vector away from capabilities that are not going to have very much impact or exploit the technology strategically. Those are the three things we set out to accomplish, and I think they might help other federal laboratories because we did have to adapt some of these tools which are commonly used in industry, like minimum viable products, to a federal laboratory. We operate differently and we accept that, you know, and so we explore what our strengths are in this context.
With this effort, we wanted to be a little more innovative in our commercialization with the technology. We wanted to transfer it as well to our soldiers in a quicker way. To do that, we worked across DEVCOM, our Soldier Center, and Army Research Laboratory to move it from discovery to commercialization.
The current challenge in DoD is we have a centralized procurement arrangement which really inhibits the ability to do minimum viable products and do very quick turns on technology maturation, whereas best practices in industry are very adept at trying to meet early product needs.
Army innovation comes from early and frequent collaboration across the S&T ecosystem. Those partnerships are really important, and things like the ARL regional offices, technology incubators and accelerators, and other innovation hubs bring together people that can work together and then develop technologies that are important for the warfighter.
The diversity of this team and the intensity over a summer enabled this minimum viable product to happen quickly and bring together a product at the end through that diversification of effort and the intensity. The metal galvanic powder developed by Army Research Lab over the past several years was ideally suited for tactical applications where you have the ability to mix gray water or black water with this powder to generate hydrogen, which then in turn can be used by a hydrogen fuel cell to create power for tactical batteries, tactical radios, tactical communication devices. But it was identified that that entire combination of fuel cell and chamber reaction chamber was a little too large to fit in a backpack, but really ideally suited for mounted or robotic applications that may be following the dismounted soldier and the squad associated with them.
We were able to successfully develop a series of minimum viable products, first at the discovery phase, then at the productization and systems level phase, and we discovered different things. Cumulatively, and working as a team of teams, that information was critical and it was complete. It allowed us to make better decisions about how to vector this technology. The other thing I can't emphasize enough, it was a team effort. It involved the Army Research Lab working with the Soldier Center. It also involved working with soldiers from different parts of the Army. It involved working with small companies and a university, including a cadet, Spencer Tess, from the Worcester Polytech.